Dear student, this is question number 56, solution S. V. Verma concept of physics from the chapter capacitance. I have selected two cases of this question. One is case 1 and another is case 2. From these cases, if you understand it, you can solve various problems, whatever problem you are facing regarding the dielectric material. And you see in case 1, let's see case 1. In case 1, that this is the diagram. I will magnify the diagram and taking two terminal, positive terminal, and suppose that another has negative terminal. Now, just imagine fictitious plates along with them. This is the one plate, and let this is the other plate. Similarly for the other one. The one plate and this is another plate. It has having potential charge positive, it has negative, it has positive and it has negative term. Area of the plate, that separation between plate, separation is D and area of the plate is A. But area of the plate remains constant. Reason being, dielectric is only field, that is a, between the plates, not on the plate. No, you are not dividing the plate. That's why half a part is divided. That's why separation becomes d by 2, because this total is d here. In half part k1 dielectric, in half part k2 dielectric. That's why you can see if this will happen here, it means total separation is d and half separation you can write d by 2. When you reconstruct the diagram after simplification, it will be like this. These are the terminals. That this is capacitance C1, this is capacitance C2. Now see carefully, it is in series combination. In series combination, net capacity can be solved by C1, C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Now put the value of C1 and C2. If you substitute the value of C1, C1 means A epsilon naught K1 divided by D by 2, you can write 2B. Similarly, multiplication of 2a epsilon, because a is constant, k2 is dielectric constant for second one, and this is d. And whole divided by, you can take 2a epsilon naught upon d common here, and I can write k1 plus k2. Now, in this problem, when you see, this will cancel out, and finally, what is the result? Let's see. That will be 2a epsilon naught k1 k2 divided by, you will find a b here also, divided by k1 plus k2. This is the capacity you can get. You can conclude here. This is the conclusion of capacity when there are two plates which is half-half, maybe one-third, one-fourth, whatever they have filled with the dielectric material. You should apply. It is only for two. If there are more than two, you can put more in series. Similarly, for the second case, let's see the second case of this question. Second case. In case two, when you redraw the diagram, this is the diagram you can draw this way, and it is divided at the middle by this way. That this is k1 and this is k2. Now put two terminals, one is positive and another is negative terminal. Now imagine fictitious plates over here. Suppose that one having fictitious plate this, another having fictitious plate this. This has negative polarity, this is positive polarity. Similarly, in this side, this has positive polarity because this may be positive terminal, and similarly this plate has negative because it is connected negative terminal. So when you reconstruct this diagram, it will be like this: one capacitance in this side and another capacitor in this side, and this will be the polarity terminal of a battery. This is, suppose there's C1 capacitor, this is C2 capacitor. In this particular case, when you see the area become A/2, reason being because plate is divided in two parts, but the separation between the plates, it will not change. I can write separation is constant, that will be D. Now when you see carefully this diagram, so it means it is net capacity which is in parallel capacity will be C1 plus C2. Now you can put here the value of C1. C1 value you can write A epsilon naught A1 divided by, because area is A/2, that's why I have written A/2, and B is the separation, plus A epsilon naught K1, A/2 is the separation, and that is A/2 is the area and B is the separation. And net capacity in case 2 you can write here, that is A epsilon naught upon 2D. This is constant in both cases, and inside the bracket you will get K1 plus K2. This is the final result. Dear students, when you face the problem, suppose that you are facing the problem of a two parallel plate capacitor having some dielectric medium between them. It may be in series, it may be in parallel. They may be mixture, series or parallel, but these are the basic rules you should apply and build your concept to qualify some competitive exams. Thank you very much.